microplastics have been found to already impact the reproductive systems of different marine organisms, including zooplankton. So once then zooplankton is eaten by other marine organisms, it becomes part of the invisible web of interactions.
We have a deal.
Yes.
Nice.
So we have two ways of sampling microplastics during this voyage. So at any given time, there's a flow of seawater that comes through the ship's flow-through system. We then filter it through a number of steps and then look under the microscope what is contained in these samples. And what we commonly find is zooplankton, and what we also found consistently in all samples is little fibers, mostly blue and black in color, that we think are microplastics. Another way of sampling deeper waters of the ocean is using the CTD cast, so the conductivity temperature depth profiler. And again, we found microplastics in all of those samples. And as soon as plastics become so small, so tiny and invisible, marine organisms mistake them for food. Secondary objective is to also observe a seabird abundance in this area that can give us an indication of ocean health.
We consider seabirds as our canaries in the coal mines. As they're one of our top marine predators, they act as early warning systems for the state of our ocean's ecosystems. From these signals or indicators, we can use these for our future management and conservation strategies.
I think that by developing an understanding and a literacy that we are not external to this world, but part of it and embedded in it, we can start transforming our actions and experience in a way that are more conductive to seeing positive outcomes at the end. We can fight biodiversity destruction or even climate change, accepting that we are of this world and not external to it.